on our part of the World Cup. It's never easy. It's the 32 best teams of the world that participate, so there is certainly a lot of effort behind it. Not much time is left until the kickoff of the World Cup in Russia. We as organizers have worked for the last 8 years towards the success of this competition. We truly hope that everyone who comes to Russia will enjoy himself there. I'll give you a few highlights of our preparations of our concept of the World Cup. The World Cup will be organized in 11 cities at 12 stadiums. Two stadiums will be in Moscow. We believe that our concept is very compact. All the cities are concentrated in the western part of our country, and the longest flight from Moscow will take only 2 hours. So it'll be truly convenient for all traveling fans. On December 1st, we have the final draw. The Kremlin in Moscow hosted this big event. This event brought significant clarity to what we're doing. We know now who's playing which team and in which city. So from December 1st, it became much easier for us to work. Although all cities in our concept are genuinely interesting and deserve a lot of attention, I'd like to begin with the cities where the German team will be playing. Mr. Grind will tell you a few words about it. These are Moscow, Luzhniki Stadium, Sochi, and Kazan. Very exciting combination of the teams that Germany will be playing with and the cities where these games will be played. Moscow is the capital of our country. It's a truly modern, cosmopolitan city with a population exceeding 12 million. It combines the spirit of history and tradition with an aura of progress and modern vibes. International guests will have a lot of interesting things to do there, we're certain. Moscow can service any interest and tailor any desires of visiting fans. Luzhniki, it's an old new stadium. It was built in 1958 originally, but it's completely renovated. The only thing remaining is the outer walls. Everything inside is very modern, very technological. We're certain that fans will have a great experience here. The stadium will host the opening game, the semi-final, and the final. Very important matches. Sochi, our beautiful southern resort. It hosted Winter Olympic Games in 2013. It features proximity of the sea and the Skibal Mountains, for which it's very famous. The stadium there was built for the Winter Olympic Games opening and closing ceremonies, but it's been modified to football mode ever since. And the stadium has already hosted the games of the Confederations Cup successfully. So now it's a purely football stadium. Kazan is another very interesting city. It's the capital of the Republic of Tatarstan. City features a big mosque and a big Orthodox church right next to it, which is very depictive of the tolerance of this city, of the diversity of the city. Kazan Arena was constructed about 4 years ago. It's home of FC Rubin. Stadium has a lot of experience in organizing Premier League matches, and also was part of our Confederations Cup plan. 8 other cities are no less exciting, no less interesting. Hopefully, German fans and the team will experience some of them, which means that it stays long in the competition. all of them are picturesque. All of them are full of cultural and historic sites. Every city with a peculiar trait, which distinguishes it from other cities. Stadiums have a capacity between 35,000 and 45,000. The only exception being Stadium of St. Petersburg, which is 67,000, and will host a lot of matches, semi-final among them. Needless to say, all cities, all authorities of the cities, all citizens of the city are very excited to receive foreign guests. Each city is making particular preparations for the teams they're going to host, finding city volunteers who speak languages of the visiting teams. We're certain that this will be a great experience.